Hi, my name is Cash and I'm in SC Azure Cloud Architect. SC means I'm security cleared, principal DevOps engineer from Cloud Solar Limited. I've got about 20 years plus experience in IT, in infrastructure and Azure. And I work for some major companies such as Microsoft, Avanar, different banks, public sector, council, etc. This is my email address if you want to get hold of me. And you can see my profile in LinkedIn. I've done lots of courses, very passionate about learning different technologies. So in this video, I'll be showing you, how to secure access to Linux virtual machine or Windows virtual machine. So this way you can access machine not from the public IP which is assigned to the machine, but using a public IP assigned by Azure Firewall. So and only using the specified port, which is SSH, which is 22, and for Windows virtual machine is 3389. So what I'll be doing here, we'll be configuring Azure Cloud Shell, which will create a storage account. We'll be creating a virtual network. Then we create a subnet, and in that we'll create and secure a virtual machine. So obviously we'll create a virtual machine, and so we'll be doing all these steps which you're doing. But I will be creating a notepad, and I'll be showing you each step by step what we're doing over here. So in the end, we'll test our machine using command prompt or the storage account we created in Azure portal, just to see that we can access this virtual machine, Linux virtual machine on port 22 using the Azure public IP address. Okay, let's get started. So this is my portal. And let's create some storage account. Click that icon over here, and you can see click show advanced settings. In the resource group, I create a new one, storage account, and I choose a location. In my location is UK South, and give a name to storage account, whatever you name it to, and use a cloud shell. Okay, so it will take a while, and as you can see, it is connected. And just close this browser for the time being. Right. Now, what we'll do, I'm gonna just make a note of everything what we're doing over here. So first thing, what we will do here, create. Basically, we have created a storage account for our Cloud Shell. Next step, what we will do, we will create virtual network and subnet. Okay, let's start it. So let's go to virtual network. Add virtual network. We choose the existing resource group. Just name it cache vnet. You can name it whatever you want to. Now we'll define the address space. So I'm choosing 172.20.0.0/16. Then we add subnet. We'll choose, call it, we just named the subnet as VM subnet, and we give the address range to this subnet, which is 172.20.1.0/26. Click add. Go to security, just leave as all default, click create. Deployment is in progress. So if you go to our virtual network, we can see all these overview of the address space we created and all that. If you just click address space, we can see the address space we defined. We go to subnets, we go to VMs, which we created VM subnet with the address space in there. Right, so next step is create virtual machine. You can create in this scenario, we will be creating a Linux Ubuntu machine. Okay, let's create a virtual machine. In the global search bar, or you can search from there, virtual machine, add virtual machine. Sorry, there, I just want to stop it because I was doing some demo yesterday. Otherwise, it will cost me, so I'm just stopping that. Click add virtual machine. Use an existing resource group. We call this virtual machine VM-1. Just leave it as default, all of that. You can see the different sizes on there, so we're choosing B2S in this case. Just important thing to know over here, we're selecting password, not SSH key in this case, so we'll be using username and password to access this machine. This is the part where it will start how to secure this machine. So we call the username whatever you want to. Call it VM administrator, password, whatever you want to do it. Normally I use demo user at different numbers and exclamation mark. So you can do that in this. And sometimes it's a bit tricky to choose a password for Azure portal. There you go. This is the where part, so we choose none. So we will not allow any port open to access this machine. This is where all the drama starts, all the fun starts. So we choose standard HD, next management, make sure the subnet is there, the VMIP there, basic stuff, just follow the screens, all default, disable that, disable auto shutdown. And next advanced, nothing in there, just leave as default. Review and create, validation passed, and then we create the machine. So it will say deployment in progress. It will take about a few minutes because it's completed now. So you can see that public IP has been assigned to this machine. So let's test this in the Azure Cloud Shell so we can access this machine or not from this public IP address. I know it should not because we have not enabled the port 22. So it will come out as a connection timeout. Just wait for a few seconds. It's just looking to, as you can see, the connection timed out. Now, what we will do, so the next step is create firewall sub Azure firewall subnet. And then firewall, Azure firewall. Okay, let's do that. So what to create subnet, as you guys know that, we'll go to our virtual network. we go to our VNet, and there we create a new subnet. Add subnet, and we'll call this Azure Firewall subnet. We'll define subnet address range. So in this will be 172.20.2.0/26. Just leave it all as default. Click save. Go to saved. Just close the screen. Now what we will do, as you can see, that two subnets are created. Now we search for Azure Firewall. As you can see, that if I click that, and we're going to add firewall, use existing resource group, and we call a name to this firewall. We call it Azure Firewall. Region we'll use UK South. We will use any policy, existing policies, we use existing. So we select our network, VNet, and we'll add a Azure Firewall IP or public IP. This is the IP from where we will be accessing this machine, not the IP, public IP provided by the virtual machine when we create it. So we call this public IP a name called AZ Firewall PIP, which PIP stands for public IP. And just leave as the default. Click OK. Don't worry about tags. Just create. Takes about 5 to 7, 10 minutes. So I'll just pause the screen. When it's ready, I'll come back. So here we go. It's completed. I just go to resources, and you can see the file where has been deployed. So we'll make a note of this public IP address. So this is the IP address from where we're going to be accessing this virtual machine, which is Linux virtual machine, using PuTTY, Azure Cloud Shell, or command prompt. So you can see that we record this public IP, and as you can see, this is a public IP address that has been assigned to this Azure Firewall. Now next step is that we'll create a NAT rule in this firewall IP. So as you can see that on the, as you can see all that on the left hand side in settings, click, we saw that already, click rules and add network address translation rule. So basically this will translate the existing IP address into the IP address which is given by firewall. We just call this NAT rule VMNET SSHH. So basically this NAT rule is for secure shell. We give them priority 500. We give a name, just call it SSH, protocol type TCP, source type, we leave it public IP address, source, and from anywhere, we just use it asterisk, destination address, put the values of destination here. This is the IP, which is the destination IP of this machine, which is a firewall IP. And the address we're translating, this is the address of the machine, the private address of the machine. Private IP is not a public IP address. So basically we're translating that public, private IP address of the virtual machines to the public IP address which was given by firewall. So now we've created this network address translation rule. Translation address is the IP address of your Azure virtual machine. That's what I said, right? And all the ticks are there, green there. I think something is missing. Yes, the last bit I missed it, which is trans. Is sorry, I forgot to show you the screen. It's a. It's a 22 port we have to add in there. So successfully added firewall. So now what we're gonna do, create an application security group. Just search in the global search bar, type in application security group. This will add, here we go, click that. Click add. We use existing resource group name. We give ASG-SSH. ASG stand for application security group. Review and create. Deployment completed. If you go to resource, you can see that the application security group is created. Let's see what's the next step. Now we configure this application security group in the VM we created. So basically, we'll go to our virtual machine which we created, and we'll go to the networking section of that virtual machines and configuration application security group. So go to virtual machine, click your virtual machine one. Go to networking part and you can see application security group. Configure the application security group, click that, and we choose the application security group we created and save. Successfully updated, that's done. Now we'll create a network security group. Click add. Choose existing resource group. We call it, we give it a name. Just call it VM subnet NSG. Create it. Create deployment in progress. Deployment successful. Go to resource. You can see that this is the security group created for that subnet. Now we'll do create an inbound rule in the NSG. So that will allow that port 22 for port 22. If we go to inbound security rules, click add. Source, we will choose that IP address. Source IP address 170.20.2.4. So this is the IP address for our firewall. Source port ranges 22. Destination, we choose application security group. And the destination application security group which we created ASGSSH, and the destination port range is 22 again. Protocol TCP. Yes, protocol TCP we'll choose. and we give a priority and name for this inbound security rule. So we call it SSH from firewall. Added. And as you can see, a rule has been added to this NSG we created for the source and this destination. The end destination, remember, we made this just created this application security group for the machine, virtual machine, and assigned to that VM subnet. Now what we'll do, we associate above NSG which we created with the VM subnet. So remember, we created the VM subnet security group, the subnet. Sorry, I have to go to virtual network. Go to my VNet. Click subnets. Go to VM subnets. And this one, we choose the one we created, the NSG. That's the rule we created. This is a machine name, and click save it. Saved. So basically, we associated that NSG we created with the VM subnet and associated that NSG. Finally, we test our secure remote access to this machine that is working using the Azure Firewall public IP address. As we know that we created that NAT rule in the Azure Firewall for the virtual machine translating into the public IP, which was given by Azure Firewall. So basically, I repeat again, we will access this machine from the firewall public IP, not the virtual machine IP, because we have translated that virtual machine IP to the Azure public IP. So we can test via opening a console in AZ portal and type this command SSH VM, the username of the machine at the public IP address which was given by firewall, as you can see, which we have recorded on top, 51.132.156.244. Copy that. If we go to our cloud shell, we don't have to put 22 because we already mentioned that only port 22 is allowed. Just copy and paste. And if we go to cloud shell, paste it there. Again, mistake. No, we don't have to mention 22. Just press enter and it should connect to the machine. Type in the password, obviously, if I remember. Here we go. It's connected. To make sure, we type the host name of the machine, and this should give you the machine name, which we did VM-1. So that's confirms. I can also test it going to my command prompt. After just drag it from my other screen to over here, just to make sure that there are different ways you can connect to this machine. You can use PuTTY, you can use Azure Cloud, you can built in portal, PowerShell portal, you can access via command prompt. You can say that now, if this we go, I just dragged it. So if I type it again, I put 22 there. I don't know why I'm keep putting that. So just take that off, 22, and that's it. You can see yes, it's connected. It will ask me for password. I will put the password. Oops, wrong password again. Let me try again. Here we go, it's connected. Just do that host name again. And here we go. So finally, success. So we have managed to access this machine by securing it, translating its private IP address into firewall IP, which we created.